Hello friends, let us learn a new topic today, which is cystinosis. It is a rare multi-system disorder, which is autosomal recessive, and it is due to mutations of cystinosin. What is a cystinosin? It is a hydrogen ion driven transporter. What does the cystinosin do? So this cystinosin, it is responsible for exporting cystine from lysosomes. Normally, so it helps in exposing cystine in the lysosomes, but here there is a mutation in cystinosin. So whenever there is mutation in cystinosin, then there is no excretion of cystine, which leads to accumulation of insoluble cystine, no exporting of cystine from lysosome. So there is accumulation of insoluble cystine. So this cystine will lead to the crystal formation in PCT and other organs. This cystinosis can occur in three forms. Number one, infantile, which is called as nephropathic, and it can occur in adolescent form and also in adult form. In infantile form, the clinical signs develop between 3 to 6 months. Okay, and in infantile form, the end stage renal disease is reached by 10 years, and in intermediate form it is reached by 15 years. So what are the clinical features of this infantile form? The major clinical features are, number one, it can be associated with Fanconi syndrome, and then there is salt and water wasting. Then growth retardation is seen, and you can see rickets, vomiting, constipation, unexplained fever. These are the things which are seen. If extra renal manifestations, these include cystine, these are due to cystine accumulation in other organs, and these include, number one, photophobia, blindness, muscular weakness from carnitine deficiency, hepatomegaly because of its accumulation in the liver, hypothyroidism, delayed pubertal development, and late onset neurological disease. And then what happens in adult form? In adult form, it is mostly asymptomatic, except photophobia. Okay, how do you diagnose? The diagnosis is by measuring increased cystine in, not in the blood, but it is in the peripheral blood leukocytes. because in the cells there will be lysosomes, right? There is increased cysteine in peripheral blood leukocytes. So how do you treat it? Treatment is replacement of fluid and electrolytes. You can give L-carnitine supplementation because of muscle wasting is due to carnitine deficiency. Cysteamine can be given. So this cysteamine will convert cysteine, which is insoluble, to cystine, which will exit in the lysosome. If there is end stage renal disease, then you should give kidney transplantation. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. This is about cystinosis. If you have any doubt, please comment it in the comment section. If you feel something is inadequate in this lecture, even then comment it in the comment section. Thank you for watching my lectures. Thank you.